Coquitlam Burk Mountain.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker. Tomorrow is International Women's Day, a day where we are to celebrate the social, economic, cultural, and political achievement of women. It's also a day where leaders across the world are pledging to take action as champions of gender parity. I think that this is something everyone in this House can support. However, Honorable Speaker, we cannot talk about gender parity without talking about childcare. And I would like to specifically talk about how childcare makes good economic sense. Among developed countries, Canada actually ranks last on childcare. And I believe that it's the BC government's failure to address this crisis that is keeping us there. We have a crisis in BC when it comes to our children in a variety of areas, and the research, evidence, and support for policy change around greater public investment in early childhood has grown and it continues to grow. In BC, there are three areas that are issues. We see fees that are far too high and increasing at rates that outpace inflation. When it comes to access, only 18% of our children under 12 in BC have access to regulated childcare spaces. And when it comes to public investment, we are the second lowest in Canada, investing only $2,200 annually per regulated space, when the Canadian average is double that at $4,000 per year. Now, looking at these numbers, I have a really hard time understanding how we in British Columbia can have the so-called best economy, but when it comes to investment in our children's most crucial time period of development, we are doing almost the worst in Canada. We need to make BC's young children and families a priority. The research is clear. The quality of a child's early experiences and early intervention matter. Too many of young BC children do not have the opportunity to participate in high-quality childcare. More than 30% of our children are entering kindergarten vulnerable in one or more areas. This is simply unacceptable. And it's costly, Honourable Speaker. It always costs less to invest early than to have to deal with issues that arise later on. So we know that early development is important, and we know without a doubt that we need to do better in this province when it comes to our children. So how does investment in childcare benefit the economy and reduce poverty, especially child poverty? There has been extensive research on this, and what we know is that affordable and widely accessible childcare more than pays for itself. So in Quebec's childcare system, it returns $1.05 back to the provincial government for every $1 invested. Ottawa recovers 44 cents even with no direct investment, and these returns continue to grow. More broadly, what we know that every public dollar invested in quality childcare returns $2.54 to the overall economy. We also know that investing in childcare has a bigger job multiplier effect than any other sector. So we hear all the time about job creation, and we hear about investing in a strong economy. So why on earth are we not doing what we can so that more children have access to quality care, so that more women can enter the workforce? The economy benefits from investments in childcare. Women and families benefit from these investments. Employers and business benefit, and our communities benefit from investments in childcare. Childcare right now is the highest cost to our families outside of housing. And in BC, that's saying something. I'd like to take a moment to give you a personal example. A few years ago, after I graduated from Douglas College, I was looking at many different childcare options based on different employment opportunities. One of the things that we were looking at was before and after school care. So I looked to a number of different childcare options in Coquitlam, and there weren't many because there's a lack of options available. But some of the options I did find were wildly unaffordable. For me to drop my children off for an hour before school and pick them up for an hour after school, it would cost us anywhere from $425 to $600 per month per child. This cost of before and after school care was going to cost us almost as much as our rent per month. So what did this mean? It meant that I looked at different employment options and we had to rely on family. But there are thousands of women in British Columbia who cannot do that. So what happens? Women typically sacrifice their careers and families have less financial stability. This directly affects the amount of women and children living in poverty in this province. If our government would take a proactive approach to childcare, what we would see is more people in the workforce, stimulating the economy with wages of working mothers and early childhood educators. We do need to diversify our economy, and we could start by doing that by investing in this sector and making life a little bit more manageable and equitable for our women and our children. Thank you.